Vegans are known for intentionally lying to and misleading people to push their agenda. Whether it's making things up about a vegan diet being healthy, that it's better for the environment, moral or ethical perspective. Vegans' lack of understanding of nutrition, agriculture, climate, all of these things actually have them doing this inadvertently for a false cause. Recently, Plant-Based News published a video with several very popular vegans, some vegan doctors, saying things that were completely incorrect. So let's take a look.
Well, meat in general is a terrible choice for athletes. As an athlete, you want to recover from workouts faster, and meat is inflammatory and slows that process down. Meat contains many compounds that cause vasoconstriction, reducing blood flow and slowing down recovery.
Meat causes vasoconstriction, reducing blood flow? I would love to put these people on the spot and have them explain their claims. The stickiness of the platelets in the blood is determined by the ratio of fatty acids in the blood. With low amounts of poly and monounsaturated fats, the blood clots very quickly. Average standard American dieter, probably 3 to 4 minutes. Eskimo's blood clots in 8 minutes, more than twice as long. This is because of their incredibly high omega-3 fatty acid consumption, as well as the high amount of poly and monounsaturated fats in the meats they are eating, the fish, the caribou, moose, whatever it may be. Fibrinogen, a blood protein, is higher in people that have had heart attacks. This is actually reduced by omega-3 consumption. Red blood cells also aren't as pliable without EPA and DHA. It gives them elasticity. I know these vegans have no understanding of omega-3s, EPA, and DHA, because if they did, they wouldn't be on a vegan diet. And if someone's going to come up to you and try to explain that grass-fed beef fat, marrow, these super high nutrient dense foods with amazing ratios of polyunsaturated and monounsaturated fats, that they are bad for you, complete nonsense.
There are a whole host of studies now that show that people who eat low carbohydrate diets or diets that are high in meat and especially processed meat over a long period of time, anywhere from 5 years to 15 years, end up suffering from increased risk for chronic diseases like hypertension, high cholesterol, chronic kidney disease, hypothyroidism, cognitive decline, insulin resistance, diabetes, cancer, you name it.
Diets consuming processed meats for 10 to 15 years suffer from increased risk of chronic disease? You don't say. How can vegans sit here and try to paint a picture about meat when people are stuffing their face with high omega-6 chicken, pork, McDonald's cheeseburgers, fried in vegetable oil? No one sane is going to believe that actual meat products, whole foods, even like venison, something you hunt, is going to be bad for you. You have to understand the context that these people are consuming the processed meat in, as well as the rest of their diet. When vegans are referring to meat eaters actually consume 70% of their calories minimum from plant foods. So aren't they plant eaters? Not only that, vegans always love referring to blue zones. But blue zones consume the same macronutrient ratios from animal foods and plant foods that Americans do. The food quality is just much higher, and there's an absence of refined foods, vegetable oils, sugar, with an emphasis on the food quality, especially in regards to animal foods.
For me, when I was eating a bunch of meat and dairy, I think by eating so much meat, I was eating a lot. I was eating about 8 chicken thighs a day and about 40 ounces of red meat a day steak. The meat that you get is filled with hormones and antibiotics, and I think by getting a lot of those, it goes into your body and then causes adverse reactions. So for me, I was always having a bloated face, and I would always have like tons of acne. I think that is from the amount of hormones that I was getting from those things.
So you ate a ton of high omega-6 chicken and were wondering why you were breaking out? It's filled with hormones, antibiotics, because you're eating awful quality meat. It's obviously ridiculous to speculate that meat is what was causing his acne without knowing the context of the rest of his diet, especially considering how common drug usage is in weightlifting, and we know what effects those drugs can have, especially in regards to causing acne.
They're all high in saturated fat. They're all high in dietary cholesterol. They've got all these components in it that are known to be disease promoting.
High saturated fat and dietary cholesterol are disease promoting? As I said earlier, those blue zones consume just as much saturated fat, if not more, than Americans do. Why do vegans continuously spout on and on when there's clearly a lack of evidence that whole foods, saturated fat and cholesterol, there is nothing bad for you in those foods. People are not dropping dead outside of steakhouses. They're dropping dead outside of fast food restaurants.
When you spend all your calories on meat, meat is not very nutritionally dense. It doesn't have a lot of minerals and vitamins. It has some, okay, but it's not really what you want. You need big quantities of it. And when you eat, you spend all your calories on meat, you are missing out on so much nutrition from vegetables, from legumes and all of that, that's what you should be eating.
Meat is not nutritionally dense. It doesn't have a lot of vitamins and minerals. These people have no clue. It is literally the opposite. They literally either did not do their research or they're lying. Either way, they don't look smart. Fruits, vegetables, grains, legumes have no fat-soluble vitamins. They are lacking vitamin A, retinol. Retinol cannot be supplemented. Vitamin B12 supplements can raise blood levels, but efficacy is questionable. D3 requires exogenous cholesterol to reach an optimal level. Vitamin K2 can be supplemented, but needs fat, and vegans are afraid of fat. Heme iron, but hey, we can all be anemic because heme iron causes cancer. Omega-3 fatty acids. Oh, well, I'm gonna have some flax seeds. You need to eat 1 cup of flax seeds to get the equivalent amount of DHA as 1 bite of fish. Not only that, animal foods have higher amounts of all vitamins that are found in plant foods, minerals, elements, everything in a more available form. These vegans are lying and uneducated.
You just got to study the literature. You got to look at the facts and you would know that having big muscles has nothing to do with eating meat. Having coronary artery disease, however, has a lot to do with eating meat.
Study the literature, look at the facts. Big muscles have to do with hypertrophy training, not animal food consumption. I think just about everyone with half a brain knows that. Coronary artery disease has to do with inflammation, not fat or cholesterol consumption. Why did the Maasai eat so much meat, yet they were immune, essentially, to heart disease?
Well, normally when you eat too much protein, it can be really hard for your body to digest. And what happens when you introduce more plant-based protein sources, you actually heal your digestive system. So you can actually absorb a lot more nutrients that you might not have been able to before. So what happens in this whole process when you give up the animal products and introduce more plant-based products like your fiber, your micronutrients, all of these things that really help recover with recovery, then everything just enhances. Your lifts go up, your running time gets better, you get stronger, you build more muscles quicker, and that's just the main benefit. And it's almost a secret weapon in any sport that I wish every athlete would adopt, because it really does give you a competitive advantage.
How exactly is fiber healthy for recovery? And what micronutrients are you getting in your plant products that I'm apparently unaware of? Is that why you're using plant protein isolates, as there are no plant foods that have a naturally high enough bioavailability for you to build your fake vegan muscles?
Brain gets less blood flow, your heart gets less blood flow if you eat a single high fat, high animal protein meal. And animal protein causes chronic inflammation. Studies have shown that people who eat animal protein are many times more likely to get sick and die prematurely than those who don't.
Your brain gets less blood flow, heart gets less blood flow, chronic inflammation. As we spoke about earlier, high quality animal foods actually thin the blood. And in regards to chronic inflammation, why do all carnivore dieters have such low C-reactive protein? The blood indicator for inflammation. Here I have a study showing an inverse association in some cases with meat consumption and inflammation.
If you're eating a lot of animal protein has more sulfur-containing amino acids. Consuming those sulfur-containing amino acids creates acid in your blood. If you have acid in your blood, your body has to mobilize calcium to bind to it. Now, we used to think that came from bone, because if you see someone in ketosis, you measure their urine, there's a lot of calcium in their urine, which mm-hmm. is kind of dangerous. Now we're finding it probably comes from their muscle, which is not good either. Now, when you look at countries that typically eat a lot of meat, they tend to actually have higher rates of osteoporosis.
Animal protein has sulfur-containing amino acids that can make your blood acidic, but so does sugar, especially fruits and grains, foods that vegans eat the most of. If you're following a vegan diet and you're consuming any significant amounts of grains or fruits, and you're saying that the body needs to be alkaline and that meat is acidic, you literally have no clue what you're talking about.
vegans have nothing to gain from trying to get you to transition to a vegan lifestyle. There's no personal gain, you know, where all these industries who are trying to get you to keep on eating meat, all these companies who are trying to get you to buy these protein shakes, whey protein, they've got something to gain from you buying that. So if you're gonna listen to either of the two, which one would you listen to?
Vegans have nothing to gain. This is comical. Grain and processed foods have the highest profit margin, and there is a huge ethical incentive and moral incentive for you to promote your vegan and plant-based way of eating. The plant-based products are far more lucrative.
What's going on, YouTube? Thank you so much for watching this video. It's a real honor to feature all of these amazing vegan athletes. And as you can see in the corner of my screen is some Vivo Life vegan protein powder. A lot of the athletes in this video actually consume that product every day. And I've got to say thank you to them for sponsoring this video. And if you want an exclusive discount on that product, please check out the link down below and you'll be able to get to their website and take advantage of the amazing discount. It's an amazing product. Thank you again to Vivo Life. I'll see you guys very soon.
Are you a comedian? You are advertising a product after saying they have nothing to gain. This is just as bad as Beyond Meat being pushed to the top of Reddit with all the fake comments on it the other day. I really don't know what to do. The vegan propaganda is getting worse and worse. What we have to understand is we are not dealing with logical, normal people that just want to follow a vegan, cruelty-free diet and live their own lives. I'm sure there are some vegans that do that, but from what I've seen, these people would rather lock you up in jail than have you consume meat. We have to not give them anything. If you give them a finger, they'll rip your whole arm off. It's very, very clear that these vegans will use any misleading, dirty tactic, and not only that, there is a ton of money and push from Eat Lancet, all of these things, all these financial incentives for the grain lobby, for reducing the health of everyone. I don't wanna go too much into that. I feel like I touch on this in every video, but hey, worst case scenario, if there's no real pushback against these vegans, go ahead. Let everyone go plant-based. When you all have Crohn's and IBS, and you're on the toilet half the day and you feel like shit and you're taking more and more medication, eventually we're going to look back on this time of vegan dieting and wonder, well, why didn't we just look at what indigenous groups ate? And notice that all of them consumed a minimum of 55 to 65% of their calories from animal foods. Huh, maybe these nutrients are key for optimal health and development. As I said in my Canada food pyramid video, people are gonna look back and say, Frankie boy was right. So, thank you guys for watching. If you guys would like to support the channel, please subscribe and share the video. If you guys would like to check out my Patreon, I'm gonna do some exclusive videos on there over the next few weeks. On my Amazon shop, you guys can find high nutrient dense animal foods, such as cod liver oil. If you guys wanna reach out to me for one-on-one consultations, all of that stuff is in the comments down below. My hygiene products, we'll be back in production in the next week or two. So if you guys are interested in tooth powder, deodorant, lip balm, moisturizing cream, I will also do my hair pomade that I'm wearing today. So definitely check out my website, frank-stefano.com. You can pre-order it if you'd like. But that's it, guys.